Charting sequence in periodontal charting. So, where do we begin? The patient opens and record what you see. By following a sequence, you can be systematic and your assistant will know what tooth you are referring to. Also, if we were to jump around the mouth, such as starting with an upper front tooth, then assessing a lower molar and then a lower canine, the operator is likely to get confused and skip an area. Some patients will perceive that you are jumping around and missing areas. If we follow a sequence, our assistant will know that sequence and it makes charting more efficient. So we have a recommended sequence.
The first step is to record missing teeth. Look in the mouth, view the radiographs, and record any missing teeth. Once we have charted missing teeth, we inspect each individual tooth. We begin at the upper right and proceed in numerical order. If the patient is missing all of their maxillary molars, we begin with tooth number 4. Begin with whichever tooth is first in numerical order. We then move tooth by tooth over to the upper left. Then, we drop down to the lower left quadrant. This is because our finger rests, our lighting, our positioning is already in place for further inspection of the left side. Then continue in numerical order to the lower right.
In periodontal charting, we have to alter the sequence. Why? Because we record information for the facial and for the lingual of each tooth. We record probe and depths, gingival bleeding, mobility, recession and whether or not plaque is present. For pocket depths, gingival recession and presence of plaque, we assess both facial and lingual. Thus, the probe and depths are recorded in these rectangles. There are 6 numbers recorded for each tooth. 3 sites on the facial, and 3 sites on the lingual. The orange ovals indicate where this information is recorded. There is an area for the facial. This is the upper orange oval. The area for the lingual of the maxillary is where the lower orange oval is located. The figure on the left depicts how we measure pocket depths. More on the process later in the presentation.
There is a tab for the maxillary arch and a tab for the mandibular arch. This is because each tooth has multiple columns and rows of information. The information for the maxillary right canine, number 6, will be recorded within the area outlined with the orange rectangle.
At the top of the charting we see 2, 5, 3. The 2 means that there is a 2 mm probe and depth at the distrofacial of number 6. The 5 indicates there is a 5 mm pocket at the straight facial. Then, there is a 3 mm probe and depth at the mesiofacial.
Here we see a charting with most of the numbers recorded. I want you to see all of the numbers, and then we will return to number 6. At the lower part of the orange rectangle, we see the numbers 3, 1, 2. The 3 means that there is a 3 mm probing depth at the distrolingual of number 6. The 1 indicates there is a 1 mm pocket at the straight lingual. Then, there is a 2 mm probing depth at the mesiofacial.
When a pocket depth is normal, like 1 to 3 millimeters, this is a healthy pocket that can be kept clean at home with brushing and flossing. When the pocket is 4 millimeters or greater, deep cleanings are needed to clean the area. The periodontal probe is placed in the pocket between the gingiva and the tooth. The probe is walked from the distrofacial to the mesiofacial, and 3 measurements are noted and recorded. The numbers 2 and 5 are commonly referred to as straight facial and straight lingual. The clinical photo shows the probe positioned about halfway between the distrofacial and the straight facial. New students always ask if this is painful or not. For some patients, there is definite discomfort. Some people are more sensitive to pain. Also, if the gingiva is inflamed or infected, then it will indeed be uncomfortable.
The probe we use is the one with the green star. Each probe design has its own distance between markings. The orange star is another popular design. These both have markings with 1 millimeter spaces. One exception is the area around number 5 on the probe with the orange star. They skip 4 and 6 to leave wider spaces. We will see why this is helpful in the next slide. The probe with a green star has black bands to serve the same purpose as the skip numbers on the other probe.
When the probe is in place, the operator needs to readily read the depth of the pocket. If every interval was the same width and color, then one would have to count backwards to decide how much of the probe is beneath the gingiva. Your course in perio will be next semester and you will learn lots more. You should have an idea of what the numbers are and what they indicate. On the right, the line in the middle of the larger intervals is 5 millimeters. So, the operator sees the 5 millimeter line and count back to 2. This is a 2 millimeter pocket.
Gingival recession is recorded similarly to how we record probing depths. 6 numbers per tooth. 3 for the facial. And 3 for the lingual. To measure gingival recession, we measure the distance between the margin of the gingiva and the CEJ. This canine has a long clinical crown due to recession of the gingiva.
Recession. The symbol for recession is the horizontal zigzag line. When plaque is present, click in the field, and the computer places a 1 to denote plaque is present here. Tooth number 1 in the example has plaque at the distal buccal, the straight buccal and the mesial buccal. The charting tells us that tooth number 2 has bleeding on probing at the distal buccal and the straight buccal. The attachment level is the sum of the pocket depth and the recession. That tells us how far apically the gingiva is attached to the root. The computer does the math after we input the recession and the probing depth. The terms pocket depth and probing depth are synonymous.
Attachment level. 6 millimeters recession plus 2 millimeters pocket depth equals 8 millimeters of attachment loss.
Mobility is recorded as 0, 1, 2, or 3. 0 is healthy, with no detectable movement. 3 is the least healthy, as it is used when the tooth moves buccolingually and is depressible in the socket. We use 2 metal instruments to check for mobility. Using your fingers to check mobility leads to false positives. The mobility score is recorded on the picture of the tooth. Click the tooth and a text field will be available.
Furcation involvement is when there is enough attachment loss that the furcation can be felt with the probe. That is a class 1 furcation involvement. Class 3 is when a probe can be passed through the furcation. The radiographs above show a molar with bone loss extending apical to the furcation. If the gingiva is no longer attached to the root, then this tooth will have some degree of furcation involvement. The symbol for a class 1 furcation employs a less than or greater than sign. A class 2 is indicated with an outline of a triangle. A class 3 is a solid triangle. The triangle will be placed on the drawing of the root in the area where the furcation involvement is located. Select the icon at the lower left-hand area of the screen.
If no mobility, record a statement in the notes. If no areas of furcation involvement are detected, then make a note. If there is no note, and no indication on the odontogram images, then the assumption is the operator did not assess the mobility or the furcation involvement. Salute summarizes your charting in this area. Are there questions? This slide can be used to check your knowledge about salute symbols and naming the restorations. Information for the maxillary teeth is on the slide.